In this video, we're continuing on with our inequalities in one triangle worksheet. Our directions for this next section are to order the sides of each triangle from shortest to longest. And remember, we have a theorem that says the largest angle is directly opposite the longest side, and another theorem that says that the longest side is directly opposite the largest angle. In the previous worksheet, we dealt with ordering the angles, so now we're going to be ordering the sides given the angles. In number 9, we're going to find the shortest angle, and that side opposite it will be the shortest side, or our first side listed. So 55 degrees is less than 62 and is less than 63. So our shortest side is going to be directly opposite that angle, side GE. So GE is the shortest side. Our next side will be the next shortest angle, which 62 degrees is less than 63. So the side directly opposite 62 is side GF. So GF is our next side listed. And then finally, our largest angle is 63 degrees. Therefore, the side directly opposite is FE. So FE is our longest side. Segment GE, segment GF, and segment FE is the solution in number 9. In number 10, 98 degrees is our largest angle, so we know that the side directly opposite that, side MN, is going to be our longest side, so that will get listed last. Our shortest side is 36, since 36 degrees is less than 46 degrees. The side directly opposite that angle is side LM, so that will get listed first. And then our last segment is the segment that falls in between. Since it is across from the angle that is neither the largest or the smallest, which is LN, side LN. So our solution number 10, segment LM is the smallest, LN is the next size up, and then MN is the largest. And number 11, remember the vertex of the angle is not included in the side that it's opposite from. So the side that angle V is opposite from is side WX. Side WX is opposite angle V. Opposite angle W will be side VX. And opposite angle X will be VW. So you can see we have WXV, VXW, VWX. We're still ordering from shortest to largest. 48 degrees is less than 50 degrees, which is less than 82 degrees. So our shortest side is side VX. Our next side is directly across from 50 degrees, so directly across from angle V, which is WX. And then our largest angle is 82 degrees, so the side directly opposite that is VW. So side VX, side WX, and then side VW, smallest to largest. Across from angle S, we will have side TU. Across from angle T, we will have side SU, and across from angle U, we will have side ST. The largest angle is 70 degrees, so SU will get listed last. The smallest angle is 50 degrees, so TU will get listed first, and then 60 degrees falls between 50 and 70, so ST will fall between the other two sides. TU, ST, and then SU is the order of the segments smallest to largest. Next, we're going to name the longest and shortest side in each triangle. In number 13, they do not give us angle A. However, from the triangle sum theorem, we know that all the angles add up to 180 degrees. 46 plus 102 is going to give us 148 degrees. So 180 minus 148 degrees will give us 32. So angle A is 32 degrees. And that's because 180 minus 46 plus 102 equals 32 degrees. So we're taking away 46 from 180 and taking away 102 to get 32 degrees. Now we can find the longest and the shortest side. The longest side is directly across the largest angle. 102 is the largest. So segment AC is the largest side. And the shortest side is directly across from the smallest angle, which is 32 degrees, our calculated angle, which is side BC. So BC is the shortest side. Largest side AC, shortest side BC. In number 14, we're given each angle. Our largest angle is 66 degrees. However, we have two separate spots in the triangle where the angles are 66 degrees. Therefore, we have two longest sides. Side EF is one of the largest sides, and also side DE. So we have EF and DE as the largest sides. And the shortest is the side that's left, which is directly across from 48 degrees, side DF. So EF and DE are the longest sides, and DF is the shortest. In number 15, it says that in triangle DEF, the measure of angle D equals 35, the measure of angle F equals 95. So the measure of angle E is going to equal 180 minus 35 plus 95, which is equal to 50 degrees. Since 180 minus 35 equals 145, and then taking away 95 from that, we get 50. Our largest side is directly opposite the largest angle, and 95 is the largest angle. The side opposite angle F is side DE. So DE is the largest side. And the smallest angle is 35 degrees, so that side is directly opposite angle D is EF. So side DE is the largest, and EF is the shortest. And lastly, for this set of directions, number 16. The shortest angle is angle M, and we know that angle M will be directly opposite side KL. And the largest is 100 degrees, which is associated with angle L, so the side that's the longest is directly opposite angle L, which is KM. So KM is the largest side, and KL is the shortest side. Next, we're on to our critical thinking questions. 17 says, in triangle ABC, AB is the longest side. So that means that the angle directly opposite that longest side, angle C, is the largest angle. 70 degrees is the measure of angle B. So it says, find the range of possible measures for angle A. So we know that angle C is the largest. So A has to be smaller than angle C. The measure of angle B is 70 degrees. So that means that angle C has to be greater than 70 degrees. If angle C were 70 degrees, 70 plus 70 would give us 140. So we know that angle A is less than 180 minus 140. Since the measure of angle C has to be greater than 70 degrees, the measure of angle B plus C has to be greater than 140. So 180 minus 140 is that upper limit of A, which is 40 degrees. So 40 degrees is greater than the measure of angle A, and we know that an angle cannot be 0 degrees if we have a triangle. So 0 degrees is less than the measure of angle A, which is less than 40 degrees. And again, that's because angle C is the largest, so it's greater than 70 degrees. So we have 70 degrees plus something greater than 70 degrees is going to be greater than 140 degrees. If we take away 140 from 180, we get that the measure of angle A has to be less than that difference, and that's less than 40 degrees, and we can't have an angle within a triangle that's 0 degrees. And number 18, in triangle XYZ, XY is the shortest side. So that means that angle Z is the smallest angle. 30 degrees is the measure of angle Y. Find the range of possible measures for angle X. So angle Z is the smallest angle. So we know that Z is less than 30 degrees because that's what Y is, and Z is the smallest angle. So if we add 30 to 30, we get 60 degrees. And if we take 60 degrees from 180, that's going to equal 120 degrees. So if Z is its largest possible, which is a number slightly less than 30 degrees, then X has to be a little bit bigger than 120 degrees. So 120 degrees is the lower limit for the measure of angle x. And the upper limit, let's say z is as small as possible, which is greater than 0. So if we were to just take away 180 minus angle y, which is 30, that's going to give us 150 degrees. However, we know that angle z has to be greater than 0, but if it was 0, x would be 150. So we know this measure of angle x has to be less than 150. So 120 degrees is less than the measure of angle x, which is less than 150 degrees for number 18. And with that answer, we wrap up the inequalities in one triangle worksheet. If you have any questions or need further clarification, leave a comment below. Also, if you haven't subscribed, go ahead, do that now, and while you're at it, give me a thumbs up on this video.